Hi, my name is Stanislav Okwad. I develop software for translators and editors called TransTools and TransTools Plus. Today, I'm going to tell you how to make Word documents look polished and professional. You have probably heard about a concept called typography. Typography is the various ways in which you can improve the visual representation of written text. There are many ways to improve the appearance and readability of the text, making a good impression on the reader and, of course, your customer. One is formatting, the choice of fonts, font weight, for example, bold or not bold, font style, for example, italic, text decoration, for instance, underlined or not underlined, and other things. It also includes the choice of correct symbols to represent written text. Another very important aspect is the spacing around words. When we edit or translate texts, the formatting of a document is already defined by the author, and we do not have much control over it. However, it is in our control to make sure that the document uses proper symbols and correct spacing. Let us look at an example of a document that does not observe typography rules. This text was taken from a Word document. To see spaces, I clicked Show Hidden Formatting Symbols button. Now, the spaces are shown as middle dots. First of all, this document doesn't read well. This is because some phrases that should be read together are broken into several lines. Second, there are extra spaces here which will be caught by keen eye. Third, there is a missing space after reference abbreviation. And finally, the degree sign in the phrase 40 degrees Celsius looks incorrect. Let us look at a few tools that will help you resolve these issues quickly and easily to create great-looking documents. TransTools and TransTools Plus offer two solutions to improve typography of a document. The first tool is called Spacing, Punctuation, and Symbol Correction Tool. It is included in TransTools Plus. This tool does several things. First, it removes excessive spaces between words and sentences, before and after certain punctuation signs, and at the end and beginning of paragraphs and lines. Even though extra spaces occupy only a small amount of space, they will cause the text to look incorrect when the text is formatted by the customer, imported into a DTP program like InDesign, or inspected by someone who has a keen eye. Also, excessive spaces are really easy to spot if the reader has made hidden formatting symbols visible in Microsoft Word or other text authoring programs. Their presence in the document can make a wrong impression. Second, Spacing, Punctuation, and Symbol Correction Tool inserts missing spaces before and after certain punctuation signs. Third, it uses non-breaking spaces instead of regular spaces to make sure that closely related text stays on the same line, making it easier to read the text correctly. For example, it uses non-breaking spaces between a number and the following unit of measurement, as in 8-bar gauge, after a word that has a number, as in table 2.2, after certain words that precede names or titles, as in Dr. Morris, inside composite names that consist of several words, as in Windows Phone, and even after short prepositions. And fourth, it uses typographically correct Unicode symbols that were designed specifically to have a certain meaning. Besides making the text easier to read, this will also prevent ambiguity. For example, it will use a degree sign instead of superscripted zero in the phrase 5 degrees Celsius. It will use a multiplication sign instead of letter X in phrases like 2x4, or it will use a single fraction sign instead of three symbols, as in this example. The second tool is called Quotation Magic. It is included in TransTools. This tool updates Word documents with correct quotation marks and apostrophes in accordance with the language typography rules or your customer's style guide. First of all, it will replace straight quotation marks and apostrophes with directional symbols, like curly quotation marks in this example. Second, it will fix wrong quotation marks using the correct quotation mark style of the document language or a different quotation mark style required by your customer. And now, I'm going to show you how to use both tools. I have opened a sample document in English. First, I will check this document for potential spacing and punctuation issues and incorrect symbols. For this, I will open Spacing, Punctuation and Symbol Correction tool from TransTools Plus ribbon. Spacing, Punctuation and Symbol Correction tool relies on profiles that contain the correction rules you want to use and their settings. The default profile contains initial recommended settings, but you are free to create your own profiles with the settings you want to use in each specific scenario. For this document, I'm going to use a profile called Video. Essentially, this is a copy of the default profile with some slight changes. Let us have a look at the settings in this profile. There are two tabs, Global Rules and Language Specific Rules. The global rules are universal rules that apply to most languages, and language-specific rules work only for certain languages if your document is in that language. First, my profile is configured to remove excessive spaces. Second, it is configured to insert missing spaces before and after certain punctuation marks. It is also configured to insert non-breaking spaces in various scenarios. The lists under each rule specify the phrases where non-breaking spaces will be inserted. For instance, if there is a regular space between a number and the word bar gauge, or a space is missing between them, a non-breaking space will be inserted there. You can add or remove phrases in these lists depending on your preferences. Also, there are a number of rules that enforce correct Unicode symbols. Finally, under Language-Specific Rules tab, you can see a number of rules that are applicable to English and other languages. These rules enforce non-breaking spaces and correct Unicode symbols. Let me now close the Profile Manager and get back to the Spacing, Punctuation and Symbol Correction tool panel. Since the document is in English, I will choose English as the document language. This way, the tool will know that the rules that apply to other languages besides English must be ignored during check-in. Now, in the preview box, I can see a summary of the rules that will be applied. Next, I will check the document using the selected profile and language. It takes some time to check the document. At the end, I can see that 71 issues have been found. In the tool panel, I can see a new tab called Search Results. Under this tab, I can see a list of all the potential issues that were found in the document. By default, they are sorted by the position in the document, but it is also possible to group them by type of issue. It is easier to review the issues when they are grouped, so I will group them. The first column allows me to specify whether the issue should be corrected by the tool or ignored. If the checkbox is checked, the issue will be corrected, otherwise the text will remain unchanged. The second column is called Certainty, and a question mark in this column indicates that the issue requires particular attention of the user. In the Found Text column, I can see the location of the issue highlighted in yellow and marked in bold, and the surrounding context. Next, in the Change To column, I can see how the tool suggests changing the document. The New Text column shows how the text will appear after the correction is applied. At the beginning of the list, I see excessive spaces between sentences and words, spaces before punctuation, for example semicolon, and spaces at the end of paragraphs. When I select each issue in the list, the corresponding place in the document is also selected. Next, there are missing spaces, for example after a comma or before the opening parenthesis. In one place, there is a missing space after the first initial of a person's name, and I would prefer to insert a non-breaking space between the initials. So I'm going to select Insert One Non-Breaking Space from the drop-down list in the Change To column. Next, I can see a group of issues related to non-breaking spaces that must be inserted before certain units of measurement like kilometer or gram. You can see a number of question marks here which indicate that the issue is noteworthy. The tool suggests inserting a non-breaking space after number 2, but since H2S is a word, I need to leave this unchanged, so I clear the checkbox here. The second issue that has the question mark does require correction, so I leave it checked. As I scroll further down the list, I see another group of issues related to non-breaking spaces between a word and the following number. All the issues in this group need to be corrected. Next, there are several issues related to the incorrect degree sign. As you can see in the found text column, the author of the document inserted a degree sign by using a zero in superscript, and sometimes even letter O in superscript. This is incorrect. So all these issues also need to be fixed. So, I have reviewed the list, and now all the issues that require correction are checked. Now, there are two things that I can do. I can correct all the checked items, or I can highlight them using a highlight color and then modify the document manually. In this case, I want to correct the issues, so I make sure that Correct Checked Items is selected. I can also indicate the highlight colors that will be applied to the corrections. This way, I can quickly scroll through the document after correction and make sure that everything is okay. Here, confident corrections are corrections of the issues that do not have the question mark in the second column, and uncertain corrections are the issues marked with a question mark. If I don't want to apply highlight color, I can simply choose Do Not Highlight from the drop-down lists. In this particular case, I do want to apply highlight colors in order to double-check the document after correcting it. Finally, I click Correct Checked Items button to fix my document. I can now scroll through the document and check that everything is okay by looking at the color highlights that were applied to corrections. At the end, I can clear the highlight colors by using Highlighting tool, which is also available as part of TransTools Plus. In the Highlighting tool, I choose Clear Highlighting command and click Clear Highlighting button to have all the highlights removed from the document. Now, I'm going to show you how to fix quotation marks and apostrophes in this document. To do this, I'm going to open Quotation Magic tool, located on TransTools ribbon. First, I need to specify the language of this document. I choose English. Once I do this, I can see that the tool suggests curly double quotation marks for the outer quotes and curly single quotation marks for the inner quotes. In other words, quotation marks that are inside other quotation marks. The symbols that have been automatically suggested are recommended by typography guidelines for the American English. If you're dealing with a document in another language, Quotation Magic will also suggest the correct quotation mark style. If I want to use double quotation marks for the inner quotes as well as the outer quotes, I can select them here. Also, it is possible to add custom quotation mark styles for a specific language by using Configure button. So, when I have specified what quotation marks I want to use, I search the document for potential issues. As you can see, the tool has found 5 instances of incorrect quotation marks and apostrophes. Now, I need to review this list and check the checkboxes for the issues that I want to correct. The first issue is a straight apostrophe. When I select it, I can also read the description of the issue in the preview box below. According to typographic rules, a straight apostrophe needs to be changed to a curly apostrophe. So this is what Quotation Magic suggests me to do here. The second issue is an opening quotation mark. Here, a single curly quotation mark is used for an outer quote, but since we want to use a curly double quotation mark, the tool suggests using it instead. If I want to change the single quotation mark to something else, I can choose another type of quotation mark from this list. I can also uncheck the checkbox if I don't want to change the quotation mark symbol. The rest of the issues are also single quotation marks that need to be changed to double quotation marks. Now, I have reviewed all the issues and decided what to do with each one. There are two things that I can do next. I can correct all the checked items, or I can highlight them using a highlight color and then modify the document manually. In this case, I want to correct the issues, so I make sure that Correct Selected Items is selected. I can also indicate the highlight colors that will be applied to the corrections. This way, I can quickly scroll through the document after correction and make sure that everything's okay. Confident corrections are corrections of the issues that have an equal symbol next to the checkbox. and uncertain corrections are all the other issues. If I don't want to apply a highlight color, I can simply choose Do Not Highlight from the drop-down lists. In this case, there is no need to double-check, so I will choose Do Not Highlight in both lists. And finally, I correct the document. Now, after correcting the document with Spacing, Punctuation and Symbol Correction tool and Quotation Magic tool, I have resolved the various typographic issues and my document is easier to read, more pleasant looking, and can be exchanged with other programs without issues. If you want to get more information about typography, one online resource that I find helpful is Typography for Lawyers. You will find the link to this website in the description of this video. If you want to speed up editing, TransTools and TransTools Plus offer a number of other tools for QA, such as Multiple Find and Replace, which allows you to check Microsoft Word documents for hundreds of potential issues by finding words, phrases, or any text matching regular expressions. Also, there is a tool called Correctomatic, which can find and correct hundreds of words and phrases at once, and even contains predefined lists for converting a document written in British English to American English or vice versa. Another QA tool called Highlighting Tool provides a number of ways to use color highlighting for your editing work. For example, you can apply highlight colors to various words, phrases, and the text matching regular expressions, and then quickly review the highlighted text to find mistakes or things to clarify. With the help of this tool, you can also navigate between color highlighting to speed up editing and clear color highlighting of specific colors when you are finished. Thank you for watching this video. Check out TransTools website to find the tools that will help you increase your productivity in translation and editing work. Click the like button if you find this video helpful and subscribe to this channel for similar videos that will be published in the future. See you in future videos.